cold urticaria, and 7 other rare diseases. There are a lot of scary, rare diseases out there. Stuff that can sneak up on you at any moment. Stuff that science has no idea how to cure. Today, we're going to talk about cold urticaria, a rare disease where you're practically allergic to the cold, and some other rare diseases that are bound to intrigue, scare, or even amaze you. But first, don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more daily tips like this and turn on notifications so you never miss our new videos, because we've got all sorts of information about strange, rare diseases that'll make you happy to be healthy. Alright, so let's talk first about cold urticaria. The National Center for Advancing Translational Sciences defines cold urticaria as a condition that affects the skin directly. They add that the easiest way to diagnose this condition is based on the presence of certain signs and symptoms. Coming up, we'll tell you the signs and symptoms of cold urticaria, as well as the causes and possible treatments for it. Causes. According to Dimitrios Theodoropoulos, MD with Allergy Associates of La Crosse, the cause of cold urticaria cannot be identified. But the National Organization for Rare Disorders explains that this condition is the most common form of urticaria, or hives. The National Center for Advancing Translational Sciences states that cold urticaria is not an inherited condition, but in rare cases has been associated with infectious diseases or blood conditions that include cryoglobulinemia, chronic lymphobic leukemia, lymphosarcoma, chickenpox, viral hepatitis, and mononucleosis. However, the familial cold urticaria, another form of this condition, has been traced to the long arm of chromosome 1, 1q40. Chromosomes are found in the nucleus of all body cells that carry the genetic characteristics of each individual. Pairs of human chromosomes are numbered from 1 through 22, with an unequal 23rd pair of X and Y chromosomes for males and 2 X chromosomes for females. Signs and symptoms. The National Organization for Rare Disorders states that in an acquired cold urticaria, the skin has an abnormal reaction to the cold. For example, after exposing your skin to cold weather or swimming in cold water, your skin will usually turn red and develop welts and itching. These symptoms may also be accompanied by a fever, anxiety, tiredness, and even fainting at times. The National Center for Advancing Translational Sciences adds that the rash will develop within 2 to 5 minutes and can last between 1 to 2 hours. The symptoms of familial cold urticaria take time to develop. Usually, it will take between 24 and 48 hours for the symptoms of familial cold urticaria to appear. In addition, these symptoms can last up to 24 hours, but in more severe cases, they can last up to 48 hours. According to the National Organization for Rare Disorders, there are subcategories of the acquired cold urticaria, the first being primary cold urticaria. This can occur between 5 and 30 minutes after exposure to the cold. Usually itching and reddening will occur first, which will then be followed by a burning sensation. Hives will then appear, which will last about 30 minutes. The exposed person may also experience headaches, wheezing, or palpitations. The second subcategory is reflex cold urticaria, which is a widespread appearance of welts, which occur when the body's temperature drops after exposure to cold applications. Treatments. There are many ways to treat cold urticaria. If you want to use over-the-counter medications, the Mayo Clinic recommends antihistamines, such as Claritin and Zyrtec. These medications will block the symptom-producing release of histamine and can treat mild symptoms of cold urticaria. The National Center for Advancing Translational Sciences provides viable treatment options for cold urticaria. The first treatment is systemic corticosteroids, which are synthetic derivatives of the natural steroid, cortisol, and have anti-inflammatory effects. They also recommend dapsone, which is used to treat certain types of skin disorders. It works by decreasing swelling and stops the growth of bacteria on the skin. All right, so now you've heard about cold urticaria. Let's go through some other rare diseases. Be warned, some of these afflictions might be scary to some. Now that the faint of heart have left, let's take a look together at some of these strange afflictions. Number 1. Hutchinson-Gilford Progeria. You can call it this or just progeria, but either way, you'd be right. The disease is so rare, it only affects about one in every 8 million children, says the people at The Motley Fool. It's a genetic mutation that causes the appearance of rapid aging in childhood, but not in a Benjamin Button or Robin Williams from Jack kind of way. You've probably seen pictures of progeria victims on Facebook, but here's what they'd probably look like. Symptoms often include baldness, a large head relative to their body size, limited range of motion, and a hardening of the arteries in many cases, which increase the chance of heart attack or stroke. Unfortunately, the victims of this rare disease don't last very long. According to The Motley Fool, in all of medical history, only about 100 cases of progeria have been documented, with few patients living into their 20s. Number 2. Methemoglobinemia. While Ronan the Accuser cosplayers and members of the Blue Man Group think it's fun to paint their skin blue, victims of this terrible skin disorder wish they could rid themselves of their blue skin. Yes, this is methemoglobinemia, or more commonly known as the blue skin disorder. As the name implies, its victims have an abnormal amount of methemoglobin, a type of hemoglobin that's transformed to carrying iron in a person's blood. For reference, most people have less than 1% methemoglobin in their bloodstream, whereas those who suffer from the blue skin disorder possess between 10% and 20% methemoglobin. If you haven't already guessed, it's the influx of methemoglobin that gives them their blue skin. Unfortunately, like most of the rare diseases on this list, you'll find that this disorder comes with a price besides strange blue skin. Victims of the affliction are at a higher risk of developing heart abnormalities, having a seizure, or even dying prematurely. The most famous case of the disease was a Kentucky family who passed down the disorder to each other for about 200 years. Jeez, talk about a bad inheritance. Number 3. Kuru. Luckily for you, there's a good chance you won't develop Kuru. Well, that is unless you live in a remote region of New Guinea and are part of the Foray tribe. The disease itself sounds pretty scary, with Discovery Health describing it as 100% lethal and causing abnormal brain tissue building, resulting in progressive and incurable brain damage. However, the way you contract the disease is even scarier. You get it by eating an infected person's brain. So, just to be clear, if you find yourself in a remote region of New Guinea, hanging out with the people of the Foray tribe, and they ask you to participate in some zombie-like activities, which would be weird considering it's been illegal since 1950, then say no! Number 4. Fields condition. There's a reason this rare disease is called Fields condition, and that's because it only affects the fields. No, not the grassy fields. We mean the Field sisters. More specifically, Christy and Catherine Fields, literally only affecting the two women. The disease is still pretty horrific. It causes painful muscle spasms up to 100 times each day and has paralyzed the two Fields. Sure, unless you're one of the two of them, you don't have to worry about it anytime soon, but you can still feel bad for them. Number 5. Fibrodysplasia Ossificans Progressiva. We know that's a mouthful, but it's better known as FOP disorder. It's best known for its main symptom, a malformed big toe. Sometimes the toe will hook inward, sometimes outward. It all depends on how a person's body reacts to the disease. Like many of the other medical issues on this list, there is no known treatment for FOP. They have attempted to remove the malformed bone through surgery, but that tends to make the body produce even more. Wow, sure does sound awful scary. Number 6. Morgellons. Sounding like some sort of medieval goblin, this disease is probably just as scary. Apparently, according to the people at NDTV Food, the disease causes biting, itching, or crawling sensations, filaments growing from the skin, and skin lesions, as well as memory loss and fatigue. The worst part? Like the other rare diseases on this list, there is no cure or treatment for Morgellons. Yeesh! What a nightmare. Number 7. RPI deficiency. Come one, come all, and witness the rarest disease in the world. Ribose 5-phosphate isomerase deficiency, or RPI deficiency, rarer than progeria, rarer than Kuru, rarer than even Fields' condition. The Journal of Molecular Medicine lets us know that this disease has had, drumroll please, only one victim. The patient, who was diagnosed in 1984, was afflicted with a white matter disease as found on an MRI, and that was finally diagnosed in 1999. The scariest part about this strange and rare disease, the molecular cause of the genetic pathway malfunction, is still, to this day, not understood. Spooky. And that's it. What did you think of our list of rare diseases? Did we make good on our promise to intrigue, scare, or even amaze you? What disease did you learn the most about? Do you have any strange or weird rare diseases that you'd like to share? Let us know in the comments section below all about the unheard of rare afflictions that we may have missed. Enjoyed this video? Hit the like button and share with your friends. Also, subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. Thanks for watching!